impersonally say, okay, okay, you start seeing that there is no pleasure in this world. Why? Because everything is temporary. An atheist will challenge. He will say, what is wrong? Temporary is there, no? You guys are foolish. You are saying it's all temporary, therefore there is no pleasure, you are saying. I am saying also that there is no permanent pleasure, but there is temporary pleasure. Let me enjoy. What is wrong with this philosophy? The impersonalist philosophy can never answer this question. Whereas Vaishnavas can answer this question. You are deprived of, yes, in absolute world, in absolute sense, there is pleasure. Why in absolute sense, absolute? Even in this material world, when you engage in devotion service, there is pleasure. That pleasure in connection with Krishna is sustainable pleasure. It will sustain not only this life, even if it is with, even if it is through these material senses, still it is sustainable. It is eternal. The pleasure that in relationship with Krishna. So we don't say, yes, yes, it is temporary pleasure, it is Maya. We call it as Mahamaya. But we don't want to get trapped into this Mahamaya's pleasure is there for you to know that there is pleasure. For you to know that in existence, somewhere, there is high quality pleasure. Varieties of pleasures. That is the Vaikuntha Loka. Oh, that is far away in Vaikuntha Loka. So, better I enjoy now what I have, what I get. So then our answer is, yeah, we are not saying don't enjoy. Enjoy. But understand that your body is limited. There are laws which govern this enjoyment. Material nature governs this enjoyment. Our scriptures also say dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Artha and kama is also there. Kama is there. Enjoy. Enjoy in an optimal way. Even now if I give you one full box of tin of rasgulla, how many you will eat? Suppose you say, I should enjoy, eat. Then you will have other problems. Isn't it? So factually there is an optimal enjoyment for everything. At this particular point of time, in this particular circumstances, how much I should enjoy, what I should enjoy, what I should not enjoy. Do's and don'ts. In other words, pleasure is not free. In the material world, if you regulate the pleasure that you give to your body and your mind according to the way the Lord has designed, that means according to dharma. Every pleasure, we don't shun pleasure. If it according to my karma, according to my destiny, that pleasure comes, one dovetails it and understands that this has to be regulated. And then one does not lose this vocabulary of variegatedness. Variegatedness. Now, if you give up variegatedness, everything is Brahman, aham Brahmasmi. No existence has no variety. But the Vaishnava never, the impersonalists cleanse their head of all the variegatedness. It doesn't exist at all. But we understand that yes, in a perverted reflection, in that manner, everything is existing here, but in absolute sense, it does exist. There are beautiful resorts, there are beautiful life, there are beautiful families, there are beautiful relationships, there are loving relationship, there are wonderful things to eat, there are wonderful things to play, the wonderful games are there. Dancing is there, singing is there. Here in the Bindu Sarovar itself, you can see all these things so nicely described. But then, you know, it's all like will of the wisp. How long the cuckoos will sing? They will die. They are everybody has to die.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.